Hey everybody, happy Worship Wednesday to you. Johnny Brush here from Fellowship Greenville, here with your midweek worship pit stop. Just to remind you that worship does not happen only on Sundays, but every day of the week, every moment we have is an opportunity to respond and worship to God. I don't know about you, but recently I have just been incredibly burdened by the onslaught of news and media and information. And last week I was really convicted and having the thought, I don't think we were designed to carry all this. It's just too much to contain. And as I was thinking about that this morning, I pulled out my handy dandy copy of Every Moment Holy. Highly recommend this book. It's by a guy named Douglas McKelvey, I believe. Yes. And it's actually similar in the vein of what I was just talking about. Every moment is holy. It's an opportunity to respond and worship to God. So it's an incredible book that has all different kinds of prayers and liturgies for really unique, specific moments in your life. And I was looking through it this morning and just so happened to find a prayer titled A Liturgy for Those Flooded by Too Much Information. So wherever you are, why don't we take a moment to breathe and be quiet, and let's let this be our prayer for today, and then we're going to sing a song. In a world so wired and interconnected, our anxious hearts are pummeled by an endless barrage of troubling news. We are daily aware of more grief, O Lord, than we can rightly consider, of more suffering and scandal than we can respond to, of more hostility, hatred, horror, and injustice than we can engage with compassion. But you, O Jesus, are not disquieted by such news of cruelty and terror and war. You are neither anxious nor overwhelmed. You carried the full weight of the suffering of a broken world when you hung upon the cross, and you carry it still. When the cacophony of universal distress unsettles us, remind us that we are but small and finite creatures, never designed to carry the vast abstractions of great burdens. For our arms are too short and our strength is too small. Justice and mercy, healing and redemption, are your great labors. And yes, it is your good pleasure to accomplish such works through your people, but you have never asked any one of us to undertake more than your grace will enable us to fulfill. Guard us then from shutting down our empathy or walling off our hearts because of the glut of unactionable misery that floods our awareness. You have many children in many places around this globe. Move each of our hearts to compassionately respond to those needs that intersect our actual lives, that in all places your body might be actively addressing the pain and brokenness of this world, each of us liberated and empowered by your Spirit to fulfill the small part of your redemptive work assigned to us. Give us discernment in the face of troubling news reports. Give us discernment to know when to pray, when to speak out, when to act, and when to simply shut off our screens and our devices and to sit quietly in your presence, casting the burdens of this world upon the strong shoulders of the one who alone is able to bear them up. Amen. Isn't that so good? So, I would like to sing with you one of the songs that I think, in all of Christian hymnody, both simultaneously helps us be humble and to worship, to remember who God is. And in singing about who He is, it reminds us that we are not Him, and that's good news. And that song is Holy, Holy, Holy. So let's sing together.
Our song shall rise.
Yes, God, you are holy. You alone sit enthroned. Together. God, you alone sit enthroned over the world, and you alone have the strength and ability to bear the burdens and weight of all of the pain in the world. And you have called us to bear the burdens of those around us, and that as we live as a unified body, all caring and loving the people that you have put in our paths, that is how we will accomplish what you want to work through us. So please help us, Holy Spirit, to appropriately bear the weight of the right amount of people and the right amount of pain around us. And when we feel the onslaught of news of everything going on around the world and we feel our limited ability, would you help us trust you, Jesus, the King of the universe, who upholds everything by the word of his power. We love you and we trust you. Amen. Well, thanks for joining us, guys. Well, not us, just me. I'm all alone in my office. I hope you feel encouraged and lifted up. Today, throughout the rest of this day, let's not worry about tomorrow. Let's think about today, because Jesus said it has enough worries of its own. Let's spend the rest of today trusting in our King Jesus and trusting that he is indeed good. See you guys.